Okay, special announcement. So August 15th at noon, I am running my own birthday event on MTG Melee. The description and links are gonna be below. It's a free event, first place prize, the winner receives, and I will mail it out to them, a sealed pre-release kit from M21. I also have second, third, and fourth place prizes because we're gonna top four. I would love it if everyone joined in. So it's going to be run on Melee, and it's going to happen next Saturday, or this Saturday coming, I guess now, once you see these, August 15th at noon. So please join me. I would love to have all of you come in and play. See you then. Hey guys, welcome everyone on YouTube and everyone in the Jank Chat. Today I'm playing in the DWC Organizational with Jessica Feather. You can join me live every Wednesday and Saturday from 7 to 11 on Twitch. You can find the description and links are below. Special thanks to our sponsor, Keke Bliss. Please check her out at kekebliss.ca. Be sure to like, share, and leave a comment below. If you want to see more from Total Jank Games, please hit subscribe. Thanks, and let's see how this tournament turns out. And we're off. Good luck, everyone out there. All right, so we've got lands and spells. And our opponent goes first.
Sure.
Because we are going to shock whatever the hell he plays. Yep. Looks like he mulliganed. Which I am totally okay with. Let it resolve, let it resolve. Do you block? I'm okay with that, I guess. Ferocidon here could be game changer. Could be game changer. If I can untap, I have a dive down and two reckless rages. So I feel pretty good. And this is probably like the first time in this tournament that I did mull to five on game one. That's an interesting. So I go reckless rage. We are attacking into this, boys, because we are going to go dive down and then into Reckless Rage. Nice. Let's see what he does. I think that was smart. Got the two biggest things off the battlefield. Oh, I should have played that. Maybe I wasn't able to. It's quite possible I missed that. Good on him. He doesn't have much of a choice but to attack. This is going to be a big turn right here. I'm still holding up dive down. Yeah, I can't change that. He takes four. I guess he leaves that up as a blocker. Well, that's good. He's gonna keep drawing cards. That's a good card to draw. I took game one. Unreal. Okay, I need this. I need this over that. And that spell pierces. I can land an Arcanist. That's so powerful. Do I want Dreadhorde Arcanist or Brazen Borrowers against Mono Blue? Oh, I guess we need to see what he's got. He's gonna bounce my creatures. Lantern, dispute, negate. Oh, he's got the Drake. And that. So, if he's got a Drake against red creatures, I feel like that's a better call. And this is better than this for the Drake. Okay, so we're not drawing any cards in this matchup. It's pretty much the way we're going with this. No drawing of cards. What is with these one-landers? Oh. Sure, I'll take that. I will get rid of Reckless Rage. Because at least Fry can... Yeah, at least Fry can kill anything. Can't be countered. Ooh. Does this mean I get to kill that and hold up Spell Pierce? I mean, that's pretty good, right? Destroy enchantment. Okay. Well, hopefully spilt. Yeah. What is happening? I don't understand what's happening, but I feel like he's got no spells in his hands. I just... Okay, so we're gonna leave up the both spell pierces. What do we got in here? We're gonna hit Reckless Rage. He's gonna draw a card. Which would be the right thing to do if he's got no spells. Okay. Because I am holding up Fry. So. He lets that go through. If he goes to draw a card here, I'm going to kill it. He doesn't. Holding up two spell pierces, I think, is very good, but in the long run, he's going to win this race. Which means I'm gonna have to do something about that.
That carries.
wonder if he tries to play something. Oh, I'm not really worried because I'm just gonna fry his butt. I mean, what's the best thing he can do here? Nothing. He's still gonna win the long race. If I don't get this off the field, or get a flyer, or get something. Ooh, that works. We can fight over this. I'm okay with that. Do I want to gain 4 life? I want counters. That way I can get Fry back. And I can kill that. Still leaves me with Spell Pierce. I think this is the right play. Yep. Yep. Just means I get to fry the creature on the next turn. Although he is going to hit me. And now I get to fry him. I am okay with that. And I get a feather. Come on. All right, well, let's do this first. Come on, let's fight over it, so that way I can cast Feather. I'm gonna block this creature. I am absolutely blocking this creature. My buddy Joe just dropped, unfortunately. Five color Niv. This is a tough match. Yep. And he'll take game two. That's five. I'm dead. Okay, do we want to make any differences? Him bouncing my stuff sucks. I didn't see any God's willings. Hopefully that's a better sideboard plan. Two colors, sure. Sure could use a third land though, but we have Spell Pierce and God's Willing as long as he does nothing to 10th Legion District Air. It's in the dryer. Come on! I just need a land. I need a land. That is the land I needed. Here we go. So, do I fight over that card? No, I don't. I hold up Spell Pierce, God's Willing. I think that's the right call here. Yeah, that's fine. Because we are definitely going to Baffling End that card. A lot of mono blue running around. That is for sure. He's got to negate that or do something, you know?